there's all sorts of weird and wonderful plants in Australia that really don't get much airtime at all. The northern hemisphere has the pine trees, and the southern hemisphere, the equivalent thing is the araucarias. In the fossil record, there was the progenitor of all of those was a thing called Willemia. In the late 90s, they discovered these trees growing just less than 100 kilometres from the CBD of Sydney in canyons. It was like discovering a brontosaurus for botanists. It's actually 200 million years old.
The downside is it has a very large and repetitive genome. That gives us a lot of challenges from the sequencing point of view. Having the NovaSeq means that we can generate a very large data set to help us to try and assemble this challenging species.
They're very sensitive to Phytophthora, which is also attacking a lot of native plants in Australia. With this technology, we can sequence genomes de novo, that is from scratch. We can resequence genomes and look at a population. We can look at different disease states. We can also discover new diseases, new pathogens.
NGS just opens up so many new research opportunities, important questions or problems that can't be solved in other ways. You don't necessarily need to have that long history of genomic and genetic information anymore. You can pick a species and you've got the capacity now to generate a lot of information very quickly.
Before next generation sequencing, we were doing sequencing the very slow way. It has made a big difference using the NovaSeq. The library prep's much quicker. We can generate huge amounts of data very quickly. We can sequence multiple genomes de novo in a couple of days. We're getting sometimes 4 terabases of data off a run, and of course that's just one flow cell, so you can theoretically produce 8 terabases of data every 2 days. Deakin's basically building up its reputation in the genomics field, and they decided to get the biggest monster truck that they could find and put it in the university. I always wanted to drive a monster truck, so now I get my chance.
Having the latest Illumina platform gives our university great scope for developing fundamental research, particularly genomics and biodiversity conservation.
We're doing a lot of different things. We're doing trees, we're doing small plants, we're doing microalgae, we're doing falcons, we're doing hundreds of different types of animals. We're building up to doing hundreds, if not thousands, of plant genomes.
We can basically do environmental surveys of biodiversity through DNA sequencing. So that's really exciting. You can not only take a water sample and identify that there are whale sharks here, but you can actually also identify their individual genetic signatures. That same technology also can be applied in things that might relate to fish health or shrimp health or environmental health. It's nice to get papers in highly cited journals that get lots of citations, but we also want to do research that actually matters to communities. So actually improving the fish or the shrimp is a really powerful strategy.
Australia's been a sort of floating aircraft carrier of exotic animals and plants. You throw a rock at random, you hit something interesting. It's great time to be working in this field.